Don't you just hate when you use your last rocket in Minecraft and you're just stranded thousands of blocks away from your house? Well, me too, and I'm tired of having to hunt down creepers just to be able to craft up every little rocket that I can. So in today's Minecraft Hardcore video, I'm going to be building up an insane creeper farm that's going to give me thousands of gunpowder an hour. We're also going to spice it up a little bit and make it look a little too fancy, I'll be honest. And if you guys go on to enjoy this video, make sure you guys smash that like button, hit subscribe, join the Paul GG army. And here's to episode 3 of Minecraft Hardcore. But in order to be able to build up our gunpowder farm, I want to put it on another giant floating island, kind of like this, because we're starting to build up our base in the sky because the comments. And I listen to you guys all the time. You guys persuade my videos heavily. So if you guys ever want to see something, just comment down below. But for now though, gunpowder farm, need to put it on an island. Island, need a lot of dirt. Don't have a lot of dirt. And to move a lot of dirt, I need a lot of dump trucks. Dump trucks? Shulker boxes. And to get shulker boxes, I'm gonna need to be in the end. So now all I need is a end city. That's literally it. So here, let's get to zooming around and hopefully we can find one. Which actually, now that I'm thinking about it, I remember the first one I found in this world was a bajillion blocks away, and this is gonna take a really long time, isn't it? Oh no, it's just a portal. Still depressed. Espresso, depresso. All right, at this point, my elytra is gonna give out before the end gives out. So like, please just stop giving me the portals. I just want an end city. Sir, do you know where an end city is? Asking for a friend, of course. I should have known better than to ask the locals. They don't like me. Oh yeah, no, they don't like me. Oh, finally. No time at all, of course. That literally was the shortest end city trip I've ever had to make. Oh God. Well, this is a tiny end city. All right, you guys better start dropping them shells, boy. Dropping them to the ground, you know what I'm saying? Now all I need to do is collect shells. Okay. All right, and after slaying all the shulkers inside of this end city, we should be chilling. We got 8 shulker boxes. Oh my God, this is not rocket. Anyways, yeah, we have plenty of shulker shells, so we should be chinchilling. And now I can be able to make my shulker boxes just like so. And then I'm also gonna dye my purse red so that I'm getting mixed up with these. Now I can be able to collect a lot of dirt because I'm thinking about not building up just one island, but maybe 2 islands. Yes. All right, and let's get to ruining Mother Nature. All right, now that we got all of our dirt and stuff in these handy dandy shulker boxes, man, I wish I got those before I went and built a giant villager head and food farm. But either way, we got all of our dirt. We're ready to build up our new giant islands because I figured that what we'll do is build one up from right here on this side as though, you know, it's coming out of the tree of life or something. And then it'll go up into another island and then up over the ocean more so. And then eventually we'll keep going up and up and up until we're at our house, because our house is going to be in the sky eventually. Because this, again, is just our temporary base. Regardless, let's get to building up all the roots and then our first island. There we go. Now we got our islands all set up. This one's going to be housing our gigantamous farm. And then this one down here, I need to still decorate everything, you know, like I need to add some like leaves and some vines and all that stuff. So like this is going to be changing a little bit too, but this is going to be like just like a little pond type thing because I am naming things in this world after my subscribers. And while doing so, I need to create like nice little environments for them to be able to strive in, you know? So like, for example, I'd be putting axolotls or like fish or, you know, squids in here, which now I'm realizing I need to make a little bit deeper so they don't crawl out. But speaking of naming things in the world after subscribers, actually in the last video I had you guys comment down below if you wanted to join the world as whatever. First of all, I offered up naming some people in the food farm or inside the villager breeder that's inside the giant villager head. But before I get to naming anything, I need to get some name tags. So here, let's just real quick extract a villager from the villager breeder. Just gonna do like a temporary set up over here for now, because eventually I am going to be building up a villager trading farm, but you know, that's down the line and I need name tags right now. So honestly, I wonder if I could just break this open. Is he just gonna, yep, that's what I figured. He's just going to go for the job. My man's take a ride, I said. There we go. And then yeah, it'll spit him out like right there, and then he should be willing to go get this job, right? Okay, yes. And then you stay in there and you live your life happily ever after, except I need to change the job because I don't like what you're trading. If I'm gonna max you out to master to give me name tags, I need you to start giving me something good. And I already know this is gonna take a really long time, so let's just whoosh. Okay, that was a really long time. However, we're able to buy name tags now. Specifically, I can buy two. Now let's head home and slap some names on these bad boys. And now the first thing that we gotta name is, well, our giant villager, actually. Which I'm not entirely certain how I'm going to do this other than maybe a name tag. So let me just slap this item frame right here on the back of his head. And Giant Doug wants to be the giant villager breeder farm. The entirety of the giant villager popping his head up out the ground. Look at all glorious. Guys, comment down below. Do you guys want to be named after farms? Because I make some of my farms look pretty epic. I'm not going to lie. Like, look at this beauty. Like, who wouldn't want to be named after Yeah, anyways, moving on. Next up, I need a villager, which actually you'll be perfect. You get to be Crimson Dawn. I can see that name. You could kind of see that. Either way, there you go. I don't have any glass on me, so that, just to make sure nothing gets in there. Like always, guys, comment down below if you guys want to participate in the world. Like I said, if you want to be named after a farm, because like I said, I make some farms look cool. Or if you want to be named after that cow. Okay, maybe not this one. Or just a villager. Comment down below, let me know. Either way, let's get back to building up. It looks like a moldy island. I need to fix that. But after I'm looking at this, I'm also realizing this island's definitely not going to be big enough. So let's just real quick start off by building our collection area, which actually I'm gonna move it over a bit more, probably like about right here, and set up all the chests with some hoppers. Hoppers going into that with a 3x3, and then we're gonna go up a couple blocks over and around all these hoppers. There we are, quite nicely. And I just need to build out two blocks on each side, just like so. And then now all I need to do is basically build a wall all the way around this and then create like a little water trap. And now all I need to do is place some gates over the center of this, bust them all open, and then just make an infinite water pool and just fill in each one of these corners. So now whenever a creeper falls, oh, forgot a corner. Now whenever a creeper falls though, the water current will just push it right down here, and then we'll have some soul fires down here, and then it'll just burn them all alive, collect all the items, and then now just build up the walls just a couple of blocks, and then create an outline above the hoppers and turn it into a little platform like this, where I then put a bed right here and just surround it with fences like so. And now all I need to do is spawn in a bunch of snow golems just like so. Probably should have sheared all these pumpkins first, but either way, ah, dang it. Just need about 16 of them. There we go. With all of our snow golems primed and ready. Now all I need to do is a bit of spawn proofing around here and then placing down some trapdoors along these ledges so that all the creepers, when they fall down, will just immediately go right into the water because they're stupid. And now this... Now this is the part that I'm slightly worried about, because I technically need to build out 11 blocks in each direction away from the farm to create a platform for all the creepers to spawn on, which as you can see is so it's pretty big. And changing the island now is kind of out of the question. So what I think I'm going to do is I'm going to shave off a few blocks here and just not go out. Oh, that was my diamond pick. Well, one of them, but come on, that is my life. Time to go with old rusty. No, I need to save that silk touch, but the efficiency one, we're in the clear. So basically what I'm trying to say though is that I'm gonna just not go out quite as far. And instead I'm gonna build it up, since, you know, the space shuttle is very tall anyways. There we go. Yeah, that should definitely work. It's still a little bit big, I'll be honest, but I do want this farm to be as effective as possible. And technically the bigger this platform is, the more creepers will spawn and the better your drops will be. Regardless, now let's just fill this in real quick, which there we go. Now everything's all set up with our platform, and then we also got all the spawn proofing for spiders as much as possible, so that hopefully we don't got to deal with them. Now I need to build up a wall along the side here, just like so, all the way around it. And then now all I need to do is painfully line the entire roof with trapdoors. Now with the slab roof done, now all I really need to do is add a couple more fences to this. Jump on top here, break this, then I need to add a piston right here. Oh, not like that, like so, pointing downward, and slap a lever on it so that it pushes the fence down like that, and all the boys get crammed into the corners. And then it's pretty much just fill in the entire roof and cover up all the slabs, except I'm going to leave this open. There we go. Now we got a whole roof on top of this thing. It's all prepped. It's all ready. Technically, this is done. This flying saucer, I guess it does kind of look like a UFO. Regardless, we're turning it into the space shuttle. Now, the only thing is that I'm going to add more layers to this. Like I said, I want it to be tall because, well, again, it needs to be tall. So we're basically going to do all this a dozen more times and build up some more layers, like one layer and two, three, four, and now we got four beautiful layers. Also, the sun is setting on day 100. So guys, in today's 100, now essentially we have four big old layers, which actually it looks like it's already working. So now you can see in action. Snowman, throw a snowball at creeper. Creeper gets mad, angry. Creeper then eventually, usually when there's not all the snowmen throwing snowballs at one, it'll fall in, but yeah, there we go. Then he falls all the way down into the water, gets cooked up, call it a day. And then now all I need to do really is just plug this up, and we got a fully functional creeper farm. And yeah, no, this thing should start ripping out a lot of gunpowder an hour. Then they get cooked up, and then all of it goes down in the chest. Now all that's really left to do is pretty much decorate this thing and make it look actually like a space shuttle, which my goal for this is this big chunky mess. Basically, oh, I fell. As I was saying, though, this big chunky mess, basically my goal is the orange part of the space shuttle, the external tank. My goal is to have that wrapped around this entire thing and go all the way up, and then we'll attach the space shuttle, and I might redo this island. It's gonna be a lot. Either way, let's get into it. Let's see real quick how this orange looks, because it looks a little dark, but honestly, I'm kind of vibing with it. And yeah, since the space shuttle is just gonna be quartz, this should be good to go pretty much. There we go. Now we got the external tank, and now all we need to do is work on the side rockets that go on each side of it, and also the space shuttle itself, which all that's gonna be pretty much made out of quartz, so we can do it all at once. Ladies and gentlemen, it is done. Our giant space shuttle that looks absolutely clunky. I love how goofy it looks, I'll be honest. Like, the space shuttle itself looks kind of baller, I'm not gonna lie. Like, that I feel like I did pretty well on. But the tank, I need to make it bigger, right? The external tank, because it just looks so fat and short. And then, of course, like, if I'm gonna extend the tank, then I gotta extend the side rockets. Because when you look at it from the side POV, but I kind of like it looking stupid, I'll be honest. Regardless, though, I actually vibe so heavy with this. And this thing has been cranking. Like, it's just the entire time it's been going, and we got a ton of gunpowder and a ton more gunpowder. Yeah, no, we're set, baby. We got all the gunpowder we're ever gonna need. I'm definitely vibing with this whole look of just maybe we upgrade it, maybe we don't. I kind of like it being stupid. For now, I'm gonna leave it looking stupid. I want you guys comment down below, do I fix it up, do I spruce it up a little bit, do I make it a little bit taller on top, and actually fix the side rockets? But also, one thing is, comment down below if you guys want to be a villager in this thing, inside the giant spaceship, inside the but yeah, comment down below if you guys want to be a villager in the giant space shuttle, because I think it would be epic to have a villager all the way in the front. Regardless, though, with our super effective gunpowder farm and our amazing, our stupid space shuttle, that is gonna be it for this video, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed it. Hit that like button if you guys enjoyed the video. Hit subscribe if you guys want to participate in the world as whatever you want to be. Comment down below, let me know. I will see you guys in the next video.